Welcome to the fifth session of Module 5, Spurgeir. In this session, we are going to discuss the derivation on length of arc of contact and numericals based on the different derivations. So first one, length of arc of contact. So here, length of arc of contact is nothing but, so arc traced by a pitch point from the beginning of engagement to the end of engagement. So to derive the equation for length of arc of contact, let us consider the two gears. One is wheel, another one is pinion. So here capital A represent the center of pinion and capital B represent center of wheel. So both the gears consist of three major circles. One is base circle, pitch circle, and addendum. So wherever the pitch circles of both the gears intersect, which is nothing but a pitch point. So let us draw a horizontal line which is passing through the centers of the two gears. So here capital P represent the pitch point. So wherever the pitch circles of the two gears meet or intersect. So now we have to draw the common tangent. So this is the common tangent. This is the common tangent to the base circles of both the gears. So next, I'm going to name this common tangent as D and C. Okay. So I'm going to join or draw a line from center of pinion to the point C. Similarly, and this line makes an angle phi with respect to this horizontal line. Similarly, from point B to point D, we are going to draw a line. And this line makes an angle phi with respect to the horizontal line. So next one, wherever this line, this tangent line, cuts the addendum circles. So this is the addendum circle of pinion. So I'm going to mark this point. Similarly, the same line cutting the addendum circle of wheel. So I'm going to mark this point. So the cutting points, I'm going to name it as E and F. Okay. So now from these points, I'm going to draw a perpendicular line. From the point F, draw a perpendicular line like this from the point F. So this line should be perpendicular to this line CD or DE. Okay, so this line should be perpendicular to this tangent line and pass through this point F. Similarly, from point E also, draw a perpendicular line. This line should be perpendicular to tangent line, but it should pass through E. Okay, so I'm going to name this one as FL. This perpendicular line FL. So whereas this line is GH. Okay. So now this perpendicular line cutting the pitch circle of pinion at this point. So I'm going to mark this one. Similarly, and I'm going to call this one as P double dash. Similarly, this perpendicular line GH cutting the pitch circle of pinion at this point. Okay, I'm going to mark this one and name this point as P dash. Okay, so here P dash P P double dash, the arc P dash P P double dash is nothing but arc of a contact. Okay, so arc of contact P dash P P double dash. So this is nothing but arc of contact. So P P P dash P P double dash is arc of contact. Then the portion P dash P is arc of approach. Then the portion P P double dash is arc of recess. So this one is similar to length of path of contact. Only thing is we are going to consider the arc here. So next one, let us consider the figure again. So to find the equation for arc of approach. So here arc of approach, from the figure, the arc P dash P is the arc of approach. So let us redraw this portion. So that is, so here we have the line FE, correct? So this is line FE. So this is line FE. So whereas here also we have, perpendicular line P double dash, then here also we have perpendicular line P dash, then a pitch circle which is passing through like this, correct? So this one is perpendicular, here this one is also perpendicular. So this is pitch point, and this is angle phi. This one is also angle phi. So now, so observe this figure. So I want arc PP dash, since this is perpendicular and this is angle phi. So therefore we can write this arc PP dash as EP by cos phi. Then arc of recess. So in this diagram, the arc P dash P, represent the arc of recess. So from the figure, so I'm going to consider this upper triangle. So here we have PP dash, right? PP dash. So in this triangle, arc PP dash can be written as FP divided by cos phi. So therefore we know that length of arc of contact is arc of approach plus arc of recess. So to derive the length of arc of contact, so we should know what is arc of approach and what is arc of recess. So if we add these two terms, we are going to obtain the equation for length of arc of contact. So this is arc of approach, this is arc of recess. If we add these two, we are going to obtain length of arc of contact. So we are adding these two equations, therefore EP divided by cos phi plus FP divided by cos phi. So cos phi we can take in the denominator, therefore EP plus FP. So what do you mean by EP plus FP? EP, so in this diagram you can see EP plus FP, which is nothing but total length EF, correct? So EF is nothing but what? In the previous derivation also, we have used the same diagram. Only difference is from the points F and E, we have drawn perpendicular line in this case. So EF is nothing but length of path of contact, right? This EF is nothing but length of path of contact. Therefore, in general, our general equation for length of arc of contact is length of path of contact divided by cos phi, because EF is length of path of contact. So next one is contact ratio. So it is also called as number of pair of teeth in contact. So here the formula for number of pair of teeth in contact is length of arc of contact divided by circular pitch. So what is the definition of a contact ratio or number of pairs of teeth in contact? Here the continuous transmission of rotation from one gear to another gear is possible. A pair of teeth
must continue to be engaged at least until the next pair of teeth comes into contact or engagement. So this is nothing but contact ratio or number of pairs of teeth in contact. Okay.
So here circular pitch is nothing but pi into m. This is nothing but circular pitch PC. So PC is nothing but circular pitch pi into m. So m is nothing but module. So let us solve a problem. So the problem statement is two mating gears with module pitch of 6.5 mm have 1947 teeth of a 20 degree pressure angle and 6.5 mm addendum. Determine the number of pairs of teeth in contact and the angle turned through by the larger wheel for one pair of teeth in contact. So determine also the ratio of a sliding velocity to rolling velocity. So at instant, so at three instant we have to determine the sliding velocity to the rolling velocity ratio. So that is the engagement commences, that is beginning of engagement, then engagement terminates, that is end of engagement, then at the pitch point. Okay, so this is the statement of the problem. Now we have to extract the given data. So first one, the module is given. So module is 6.5 mm. Okay, so here 19 is nothing but the number of teeth on pinion. So which is nothing but small t. So 47 represent number of teeth on wheel. That is capital T 47. So pressure angle is nothing but phi, which is 20 degree. Then addendum is 6.5. Addendum is represented by small letter A. So these are the given data. So for this, we have to first find number of pairs of teeth in contact, which is nothing but contact ratio. So in the previous slide, we have explained what is contact ratio. So first one, we have to find number of pairs of teeth in contact or contact ratio, then ratio of a sliding velocity to rolling velocity at three different condition. So to find the number of pairs of teeth in contact, so first we have to calculate length of a path of contact. So we know that to find the radius of the pinion, so this is the formula, R is equals to M into T divided by 2. So module given is 6.5, whereas number of teeth on pinion is 19. So therefore MT divided by 2, 6.5 into 19 by 2. So after simplification, we got 61.75. This is the pitch circle radius of a pinion. Similarly, pitch circle radius of a gear, we have to find capital R is equals to module times of number of teeth on wheel or gear divided by 2. That is 6.5 into 47 divided by 2. So we got capital R is equals to 152.75 millimeter. Next. So radius of addendum circle of pinion, so which is nothing but RA is equals to R plus A. Because we know so this is the base circle, this is pitch circle and this is addendum circle, correct? This is addendum circle. This distance between pitch circle and addendum circle is nothing but this addendum height. Therefore, This is R. So R plus A gives the radius of a addendum circle. Next one. So radius of addendum circle of a gear, that is RA, is equals to R plus A. So capital R we got 152.75, then add the addendum 6.5. This is the addendum radius of a gear, 159.25 millimeter. So next, length of path of recess. So first we have to find the length of path of recess, then length of a path of approach. Then if we add these two, we are going to obtain the length of path of contact. So this is the formula. So in the derivation also we have used PE. PE represents the length of path of recess. So this is the formula. In this formula, RA value is 68.25 and R is 61.75. Phi value is 20 degree. So substitute all the values. So after substituting, we have to simplify this. So therefore, length of path of recess PE is equals to 14.81 millimeter. Similarly, we have to find length of path of approach, that is PF or FP, is equals to root of capital R A square minus R square cos square phi minus R into sin phi. So R A radius, addendum radius, we got 159.25, substitute here, and radius is 152.75, substitute here. Phi value is 20 degree and R value is 152.75, phi value is 20 degree. Substitute all the values and simplify. After simplifying, we got length of path of approach 16.7302 millimeter. So the length of path of contact is nothing but, so the addition of these two, that is path of approach and path of recess. EF is equals to PE plus FP. So PE value we got 14.813, whereas FP value 16.73. So add these two value, we are going to obtain the length of path of contact. So therefore, length of path of contact value is 31.54 millimeter. So next one, we have to calculate the number of pairs of teeth in contact. So which is nothing but contact ratio. This is nothing but contact ratio. And second one is angle turned by gear. So we know the formula for length of arc of contact. So length of arc of contact is equals to length of path of contact by cos phi. So in the previous step, we have determined length of path of contact. So that is 31.5415, and phi value is 20 degree. Therefore, cos 20 degree. After simplifying this, we got 33.56 millimeter. This is nothing but a length of a arc of contact. So, but to find the contact ratio or number of pairs of teeth in contact, So this is the formula, length of arc of contact by circular pitch. So length of arc of contact 33.56, whereas circular pitch formula is phi into m. M is the module. So therefore, so module value is a 6.5 given in the problem. Therefore, after simplifying this, contact ratio or number of pairs of teeth in contact is 1.64. So because we are finding the number of teeth, so we are getting the fraction value. So it is not possible to cut 1.6 number of teeth. Therefore, we go for the next number. So 2. 2 is the number of pairs of teeth in contact. Next one. length or circumference of the gear. How to find the circumference of the gear? Since it is a circular one, 2 pi multiplied by the radius. 2 pi multiplied by the radius give the circumference of a gear. So radius of the pitch circle is 152.75. Therefore, circumference of the gear is 959.75 millimeter. So what does it mean? So here it is nothing but for 360 degree, the length of the gear is 959.75 millimeter. For 365 degree of gear, the length of the gear is 959.75 millimeter. Therefore, for 33.56 mm length, so this is length of arc of contact, right? For 33.5657 mm length, the angle is, that is theta is equals to this 33.5657 multiplied by the total, that is 360 degree divided by length of the gear. Okay, length of the gear, that is 959.75. So therefore the angle turned by the gear is 12.59 degree. Angle turned by the gear is 12.59 degree. So next is in the step 3, we have to calculate the ratio of a sliding velocity to rolling velocity. So in the problem, it is given for the 3 case, we have to find this velocity ratio, that is sliding velocity to rolling velocity. So the first case, so the ratio of sliding velocity rolling velocity when engagement terminates. So here we have to take the ratio, that is velocity of sliding velocity. So here SE represent the sliding velocity, then whereas VR represent the rolling velocity. So VS represent the sliding velocity, VR represent the rolling velocity. And we know that in the figure, EF and P, this is pitch point, this is length of path of contact, so length of path of contact, this is, so there are two regions from EP, path of approach, this is path of recess, correct? So here we are considering, so VS represent the sliding velocity, VR represent the rolling velocity. So here E is the starting point of the engagement, therefore we have considered VSE, sliding velocity at E, rolling velocity at E. So this is the formula, that is PE, this distance PE divided by radius, pitch circle radius of a pinion into 1 plus gear ratio small t by capital T. Therefore, so PE is 14.81, whereas R value is 61.75. Number of teeth on pinion is 19, number of teeth on gear is 47. So after simplifying this, we got velocity ratio 0.3368. Similarly, for the commencement of engagement, so we have to use the formula VSF. So here this is beginning of engagement, this is end of engagement, okay? This is end of engagement, not the commence, okay? This is commence and this is end, a slight change in the statement. So this is beginning of engagement, whereas here end of engagement takes place. The sliding velocity at point F divided by sliding rolling velocity at F is equals to this distance FP divided by radius, pitch circle radius of pinion multiplied by 1 plus gear ratio small t by capital T. So FP is 16.73, whereas radius is 61.75. This is 19 and this is 47. After simplifying this, we got 0.3804. Whereas the third case, so at pitch point, so what happens at pitch point? See, this is pitch point. This one is the pitch point. So here we won't get any length. Exactly at the center, we don't have any length. Therefore, velocity ratio become 0. Velocity ratio become 0. So next problem. Two gear wheels mesh externally and are to give a velocity ratio of 3. So G value is given, velocity ratio. The teeth are of involute form. Module is 6 mm, M value is given. Addendum is 1 times of a module. Please don't get confused. This is not 1 meter, 1 times of module. So 1 into M. So pressure angle is 20 degree. The pinion rotates at 90 RPM. Speed of the pinion is given. So find first one, number of teeth on pinion to avoid the interference. And the corresponding number on the wheel. So that is, so capital T we have to find. The length of path of contact and length of arc of contact. Then the number of pairs of teeth in contact or contact ratio we have to find. The maximum velocity of a sliding. So this also we have to find. So first we have to extract the given data from the statement. So module given is 6 mm, pressure angle is 20 degree, G is nothing but velocity ratio. So 3:1, or we can take directly 3. So addendum of both pinion as well as wheel is 1 times of a module. So in order to avoid the interference, so we know that we have to multiply. So in the derivation also we have used the same thing. Suppose for the wheel, so in order to avoid the interference we have to multiply addendum by module. So therefore here 1 times of module is given. So addendum of a pinion as well as wheel is equals to 1 into M. So 1 into 6, therefore 6 mm. So therefore addendum of a pinion or addendum of wheel, so both in the problem it is given 1. Okay, so speed of a pinion is given, I will consider it as N1, 90 RPM. So therefore omega 1 is equals to 2 pi N1 by 60. Since this is the driver, pinion is the driver, therefore speed of driver is 90 RPM. So omega 1 value becomes 9.4247 radians per second. So we have to find number of teeth on gear as well as pinion. Next, length of path of contact, length of arc of contact, then contact ratio D, and maximum velocity of sliding. So next one, first step is we have to calculate the number of teeth on both pinion as well as gear. So the gear ratio is given, G is equals to 3. So but to find the minimum number of teeth on gear and pinion to avoid the interferences, this is the formula, right? So capital T is equals to 2 into AW divided by root of 1 plus sine square phi into 1 by G into G plus 2 plus minus 1. So G value is 3, phi is 20 degree. So AW, that is addendum of wheel, is 1. Substitute all the values and simplify it. So minimum number of teeth we got 44.94. So we have to take the next value. Whenever there is a number of teeth, then we have to consider the standard numbers or round of values. So not the fractions like this. So therefore, the 45 number of teeth on a wheel. Similarly, to find the minimum number of teeth on pinion, we are using gear ratio. G is equals to capital T by small t. So G value given in the problem is 3. So capital T we got 45. Therefore, 3 is equals to 45 by T. So small t is equals to 15. So we got number of teeth on a pinion is 15. So next step is calculate the length of a path of contact. So to find the length of path of contact, we should know the radius values, because in the formula we have R and RA value. So that's why initially we have to find R and RA value. So R is equals to MT by 2, therefore 45, the pitch circle radius of pinion. Similarly, pitch circle radius of gear is M capital T by 2, therefore 135. After simplifying, we got 135. And RA value, so RA is equals to R plus AP, okay, addendum of a pinion, radius and addendum of pinion. So radius is 45, whereas addendum is 6, therefore 51, radius of the addendum is 51 mm. Similarly, radius of addendum of gear is capital RA is equals to capital R plus addendum of wheel. So the radius is 135, addendum of wheel is 6, therefore 141 is the addendum radius of gear. Next, length of approach. So length of approach is FP is equals to root of RA square minus R square cos square phi minus R sin phi. So RA is 141, R is 135, phi is 20 degree. Here R is 135. Substitute and simplify it. Therefore, length of path of approach is 15.37 millimeter. Similarly, the length of path of recess, which is PE, is equals to root of small RA whole square minus R square cos square phi minus R sin phi. Substitute RA and R value and phi values and simplify it. So the length of path of recess is 13.12 millimeter. So to find the length of path of contact, we have to add both path of approach and path of recess. That is, EF is equals to FP plus PE. 15.37 plus 13.12. So therefore, the total length of path of contact is 28.49 millimeter. So next step is we have to calculate the length of arc of contact. So we have the relation between arc of contact and path of contact. That is, length of arc of contact is equals to path of contact by cos phi. So path of contact we got 28.49. So therefore, so after simplifying this, we got length of arc of contact 30.32 millimeter. So in the next step, we have to calculate the number of pair of teeth in contact or contact ratio. So contact ratio is equals to length of arc of contact divided by circular pitch. Circular pitch formula is pi into m. Therefore, length of arc of contact we got 30.32, and circular pitch formula is pi into m, modulus 6. After simplifying this, we got 1.60, that is number of pairs of teeth in contact. Therefore, we have to take the next number, we have to round it off. Therefore, we got 2, contact ratio 2. Then the maximum velocity of sliding, the formula is omega 1 plus omega 2 into the distance. So but omega 1 value is known, omega 2 is known, don't know. Therefore, we have to calculate omega 2 value using gear ratio. G is equals to omega 1 by omega 2. So omega 1 is 9.42, G value is 3. Therefore, omega 2 becomes 3.14 radians per second. Then the velocity. So the velocity formula is omega 1 plus omega 2 into the distance, path of approach distance, right? So therefore omega 1 is 9.42, omega 2 is 3.14. so FP is nothing but path of approach, which is 15.37. so after simplifying this, we got the velocity value 0.193 meter per second, or 193.18 millimeter per second.